Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to another quick pick prediction video. In this video, I'll be predicting a middleweight bout between Roman Dolidze versus Laureano Staropoli. And so you got a former light heavyweight in Dolidze versus a former welterweight in Laureano Staropoli. When I see this one right here, Staropoli, even though like a lot of times these fighters go up, they feel like they don't have a technical advantage or a speed advantage. He will have a speed advantage on for sure, but he's not the most technical fighter. He's was like a younger fighter, not super young, but still like not nearing his prime, still I guess relatively early into his UFC career. And really, with one of the fights is, like I said, he's not a bad fighter at all. It's just, we're really like, in the most broadest sense, what made him stand out, allow him to get victory was he relentless, active, and aggressive. Like this, he put on a pace out there. He'll put on pace. So he'll outwork and outland his opponents. And that's really what he is. He's a volume fighter, or he's an activity fighter. He's not a fighter, like this guy's technique is so clean, he's so sharp. His defense is so like tight, and he's so good on the counter, so quick, got such great footwork and stuff, such good head movement. He's not. He's just a fighter that swings some big shots. He'll throw a lot of volume, throw some flying knees, throw some spinning kicks. He'll be active, and that's what he is. So going up a weight class, now fighting a guy who's bigger than you and more well-rounded than you, and you got taken down like three times by Muslim Salikov, who only recently been involved with, like, well, it's probably been 2 years now. He's been working more so on his wrestling and jiu-jitsu and all that, but still, at the time he beat you, was relatively newer to him. He was relatively revamping that game. He went out to take you down three times with relative ease. Now strike you, be cleaner, be crisper, and like, yeah, it's not a good look to be taken down three times. And really looking at his record, there's been a couple fights where he's been taken down, and I haven't seen him have really great success. I think he had like one fight he got a takedown, and then also in that fight he got taken down. So his offensive, his grappling not impressing me. So really he's just a volume striker with not much else to his game. Like, I mean, you probably trained it because he would obviously have been submitted if it was like non-existent, but as far as relatively, you would want a guy that's not getting taken down, not getting held down, and probably holding people to a one takedown on average or less, or well, it can be less than that, but you would want that. But I'm not saying that from Staropoli, then striking-wise. But yeah, not really impressed with his grappling. But to conclude this one up, I do think there's some flaws in Giles, not so Giles, Dolidze's side as well. Like his head movement is really not the best. His striking, very slow. Well, to me, it looks very amateurish in a way. But again, a guy with a lot of still very big, got that grappling background that, you know, they got to respect. But again, like a lot of sloppy, amateurs looking striking from Dolidze. But going against, he fought Trevin Giles, who I feel is a better opponent than Staropoli. Better striker, definitely much better boxer. Matter of fact, just a much cleaner striker in general than Staropoli. An actual middleweight and not a welterweight. And he didn't look too bad against him on field, and overall, it didn't look too bad against him. He really didn't. He was doing that textbook Jackson Wink striking, a lot of little stepping sidekick, little teeps and stuff. Like I said, didn't look as smooth as some of the other Jackson Wink fighters like Holly Holm or John Jones, obviously not, but still, like, he's working there. He's, like, striking. I think he knows his striking isn't the best or isn't the greatest, but it's mixed martial arts. It's not a striking sport. Like I said, maybe in pure striking, Staropoli would probably beat him, but the fact that's MMA fighting, Staropoli's grappling, defense, and offense has not looked the best. I think the larger man will be able to find takedowns on Staropoli on the feet. Keep it up. Like, keep the volume close, mixing takedowns, get cage control, get takedown, and really just, like I said, take it to a decision. I feel like if Dolidze was, you know, had better grappling IQ as far as MMA, because I feel like a lot of positions he could have went for, pretty much he could, like, you know, when you look at higher level grapplers in MMA, like, it could be where people, they could make you make mistakes that would make you present finishes or not chase up. Like, he'll have a dominant position and go for a leg lock, which isn't the smartest thing unless you're Paul Harris or something, and that's what you do, or what you have been done consistently at the highest level, and then maybe you go for that stuff. What if you're not that dude or one of those dudes, don't do that, because that gives up your position. Like, he could control the dominant position, land ground a pound, land elbows, cut his opponent up, bust him up, then force him to make mistakes, try to turn over, dig an arm triangle or something. Like I said, I don't see the highest grappling IQ. Like, he has the skills, it's definitely there. But as far as getting the finish and, or, you know, doing what he needs to do, or making the right decision that you're not spending as much energy, make your opponent spend that energy, and make your opponent make mistakes instead of trying to force things. That's why I feel like with Dolidze, he forces a lot of things in his grappling as far as in MMA, probably in his combat, I mean, and actual BJJ as well. But all I'm saying, it'll probably be opportunities for him to get submissions, but he's probably not going to get a finish in this one. I just think it's going to be a decision, probably a little bit close, but still relatively clean and easy for the judges to score. So in this one, I got Roman Dolez by decision.